better place. We have 40 days to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. By the help of God, to make our world a better place.
So, hi from two students. My name is Teacher Benjamin. I'm going to take you maths. And today, I want us to look at the topic gradients and equations of straight lines. Now, first of all, we need to understand what we mean by gradient. When we talk about, when we talk of a gradient of a line, we are simply talking about the slopeness of a line. If, for example, because in Form 1, you are drawing straight lines, when you are looking at solving simultaneous equations using the graphical method, if I have a line here, let me assume that is my line, passing through two points, P and point Q, and we assume that here, this is 2, this is 4, this is 7, this is 8, that way. So, remember, from Form 1, we read coordinates as x, y. So, P, our P here is x, y. So, it is 2, 4. So, most of the students usually do it the other way around. That is y, x. But it is x, y. We give coordinate as x, y. So, we start with x. That is 2, then y. So, point P is 2, 4. Point Q here is 7. That is x. Y, 8. So those are the coordinates. So if I want to find the slopeness of this line, or if I want to find the gradient of this line, if I come here and draw a right angled triangle here, at this point here, the coordinate of this point can be, or should be, 7, 7. Remember this 7 is the same 7 which is here. Then, meaning they are sharing, this point and this one are sharing the x. Then this one, 4. Remember, this 4 is the 4 which is here, meaning they are sharing the y value. Now, when we are finding the gradient of that line, we usually say it is the vertical distance. We all know vertical is this line here, over horizontal. Horizontal distance. So we need to know this distance here. This is our vertical distance. Remember, the unit here is 4, here is 8. So you get the difference. The difference is 8, you subtract 4. Over the horizontal distance, we want to know how many units are from here to here. So it is 7 minus 2. So we have 7 minus 2. So this is 4 over, this is 5. So 4 over 5 becomes the gradient of that line. Or it becomes the what? The slopeness of that particular line. Now, before we start on the real things, now this one I was just explaining to you what we mean by gradient. Let me introduce you to 4 different types of lines that we can have. So the first line that we can have in any question is a line that looks like this. A line that looks like that, like the one that we just looked at. So we can maybe change P, then Q. So here we say is like 1, 4. So it is 1, 4. Remember that is how we read coordinates as X, Y. X, Y. This one we assume it is 9. This one we assume is 8. So this one is 9, 8. It is not 8, 9. It is x, y. So it is 9, 8. So for this line, the gradient, if you want to find the gradient, we usually find the gradient as change in y over change in x. In the previous one, I talked about the vertical
distance, the vertical distance, you know, that is what we refer to as change in y, over the horizontal distance, change in x. Now, there is an easier way of doing this. If we agree this is our first point, this one here is x1. This one becomes our y1. 9 is our x2 because generally q, we are taking q to be our second point. And 8 becomes y2. So when you talk about change in y, it can either be y1 minus x1. Change in y, y1 minus y2. Over x1 minus x2. Change in y over change in x. Or you can do it the other way around. Y2 minus y1. I've interchanged now these ones. But now for consistency, even for the denominator, you start with the second point, that is x2 minus x1. That way. Now let us come to our line here now. Our line here, our y1 is this one, so it is 4 minus 8 over 1 minus 9. So we have negative 4 over negative 8, which is a half. We know that one from integers in form 1. So generally, for now, I do not even want you, first of all, to dwell so much about the figure. I want to dwell you to dwell much on the sign that has been taken by that figure. For example, when you talk of a half, it means that the gradient for this line is positive. It is a positive gradient. So for this one, we've seen it is positive. So I said I'm going to introduce you to four different types of lines. So this line, the gradient is positive. Let us look at another line that looks like this. Now this one looks this way. So again, we can have our point P there and our point Q there. So we assume that this point is 2, 8. This is 2, 8, we are assuming. So for this one, we assume it is 10, 5. So this one is 10, X, Y. X, Y, that way. So the gradient, now we can move a little bit faster. The gradient is change in Y over change in X. Change in Y. So if we take this one to be our first point, remember this is X1, Y1. X2, Y2. So we can say Y1 minus Y2 over X1, because here we started with 1, minus X2. So if this is our first point, it will be 5 minus 8 over 10 minus 2. 10 minus 2. So this is negative 3 over 8. Yeah? Let us not, again, dwell so much on this figure here. My interest for this time is now the sign. So you have realized, for such a line, the gradient is negative. The gradient is negative. So for that line, the gradient is negative. The other line will look like this. There is this line that looks like this, parallel to the x-axis. Parallel to the x-axis. So that here is 5. Then you can take a point there and a point here, P, Q. This one is 2. This one we can take it to be 7. So if we do change in y or change in x, because our P is 2, 5, and our Q is 7, 5. So change in y over change in x will be 5 minus 5. 5 minus 5. Now we can move faster because now we've known how to go about it. Over 7 minus 2. 7 minus 2. You get 0 over 5. Any number, you... when you divide 0 by any number, the answer is 0. The answer is 0. Remember, in integers in form 1, 0 is neither a negative nor a positive. So, it is worth noting now, for such a line, any line that is parallel to the x-axis, the gradient is 0. The gradient is 0. Why is it in 0? It is zero because none of the ends has been raised so that you can have a slopeness or a gradient. So for that reason, the slopeness or the gradient for such a line is zero. The last line that I want us to look at is now a line that is parallel to the y-axis. So here we can assume this is 4, then 7, 2. So this is PQ. Huh? Our P is 4x for the y, 7. Our Q is 4 for the x, for the y, 2. So if we do change in y, but change in x, 7 minus 2, 7 minus 2 over 4 minus 4. You get 5 over 0. Now, mathematically, 5 over 0 is not the same as 0 over 5. 5 over 0 is infinitely a big number, a number that we cannot mention. And for that reason, we usually say the gradient for such a line that is parallel to the y-axis, is undefined. We say the gradient is undefined. So those are the four types of lines that I would like us to look at. Such a line where the gradient is positive, the gradient is negative, the gradient is zero, and here the gradient is undefined.